giving da'wah or spreading the word of Islam can come in different forms and not given solely via speech, preaching, or passing literature. In fact, the most effective and significant way to demonstrate and teach Islam is by having a good character, good personality, good manners, being kind, gentle, honest, truthful, and living by example, and being a good role model. It becomes imperative for the caller of Islam to possess these characteristics to effectively convey the message. In fact, before a person or a community invites others to Islam, there need to be certain good qualities established in them to hold credibility and strength, like truthfulness, good morals, good manners, good character, ability to rely on them, etc. So the message they carry can hold strong and can be taken seriously by others. Without these qualities, the message one delivers will not carry any weight, nor will it be taken seriously by others. One's message will not be taken seriously if their character or action is not good or line up with what they are preaching, nor would anyone believe what that person is saying if they steal, lie, or cheat. Our Prophet was known as the truthful, the trustworthy amongst his community decades before he started preaching Islam. Da'wah also involves helping and reminding other Muslims who may be lacking in certain areas of their religion by commanding good and forbidding evil. It should be noted that not everyone is intended to be a scholar or a preacher, and that da'wah comes in many different forms. People can engage in da'wah in many ways to benefit people and society. It is the duty of every Muslim to better his or her family, community, and society to the best of their ability. A Muslim should be involved in and committed to the forefront of battles and struggles against racism, injustice, poverty, aggression, etc. A Muslim is one that gives back to his community and society, and is not one that is selfish and only self-serving. A Muslim is one that serves something of value to others, making a positive change and impact on others. Whether it comes in the form of volunteering, social work, helping local orphanages, helping the poor, counseling, political activism, building schools, or advising one's peer or community youth. For example, a Muslim doctor should devote one day a week or a month to give back to his community by offering free services to those who do not have healthcare or volunteering at a free clinic. One needs to ponder and reflect over his or her own talents, unique skills, strengths, education, background, and personality, discovering those specific qualities that God has gifted them that they can be used to benefit others. That gift can come in form of teaching others, creativity, leadership, knowledge, etc. Our Ummah, Islamic community, needs help and services from all angles. God's last and final prophet stated, "The most beloved to Allah are the most beneficial to the people." Whereas a Muslim does not perform these deeds with the intention to show off to others, their display in public can become a good means of da'wah to non-Muslims, or even, for that matter, to weak or non-practicing Muslims. One can become inspired and curious about Islam when seeing a female Muslim doctor or nurse with hijab on representing Islam by volunteering and offering complimentary services at a free clinic. The one that engages in work of da'wah needs to